Alright folks, today I'm gonna show you how to make this grilled mushroom meat pan. It's time to grill! And we are starting with chopping up the veggies, onions and mushrooms. Of course, we are speeding this a little bit up for you. If you want to have the exact amount of ingredients, just make sure to visit the video description. We have everything in there. This is a great looking piece of Iberico pork from my favorite online butchery gourmetfleisch.de. I will put a link into the video description. You might check it out there. And best thing is, if you get the pieces like this and you cut them into steaks, you will now be able to cut the steaks as thick as you want. And I want them thicker, because we want to play with the color and the internal temperature, and it's easier to control if you don't cut it too thin. So great marbling here, great fat share. It's really, really good, and I'm amazed by the quality here. Some of you might have seen my video for a mushroom rub, which came out lately. I will put a link at the end of the video so you can check it out. And next step is prepare two of the steaks with the mushroom rub. We're gonna get started with some oil. And after covering the two steaks in oil, we add the mushroom rub. The other pieces of pork will be only grilled covered in salt, and these are covered in the mushroom rub. If you might have seen the video, you know that there are a lot of ingredients in there, and we leave them now in the fridge for approximately 2 hours. And these are some really great looking marinated pork chops. In the meantime, they are refrigerating. I have started a starting chimney with charcoal briquettes, and I've pulled out my Weber kettle again. And we take the two charcoal baskets, we fill them up with the charcoal briquettes, and that's the fast and easiest way to get nice burnt charcoals. Then we move them to one side so we have enough space for direct heat and enough space for indirect heat, and then we put on the grill grates. Then I close the lid and open all the vents just to have some temperature coming up, and I have to clean the grill grates with a brush. Then I have already grilled the salted versions of the pork steaks, and this helps to lose a little bit of the temperature of the charcoal briquettes, and we are now able to grill the mushroom version approximately 2 minutes per side. We want some roast flavors here, so a little bit darker. I like that today. Make sure not to burn them too long here, but these are just fine. After grilling these, I have flipped them over to indirect heat. That's it. And then we are starting to make the pan with the mushrooms. A little bit of oil and bacon. In Germany we call this dish and that sauce Jägerpfanne or Jägersoße, which would be a word-by-word translation of hunter pan or something like that. And it's my favorite sauce to go with schnitzel, for example. And today we are just using that one for covering the Iberico pork chops later on. So we have some great direct heat here on the cast iron pan, and we are now starting with the bacon. After letting the bacon sit in there and have some of the fat rendering out, we add onions. We really want a strong flavor today, that's why I leave the bacon and the onions in the pan on high heat for a longer time. and I'm not afraid of burning it a little bit. It gives additional flavor that we are wanting here today. So make sure not to burn it completely, of course, but a little bit of brown onions and bacon is good for that dish. Of course, we could have made a easier, lighter version with white wine and garlic, which would be great as well, but for today it has to be the strong flavor. So after adding the mushrooms and 2 minutes more, we are adding light soy sauce here and beer. Half a bottle of beer, 250 milliliters should work here, and we have now the flavors from the small little bit burnt onions and the bacon go into the beer and into the soy sauce, and that is really, really also already a really great color. We are now changing the position on the grill to indirect heat. We are closing the lid for 5 till 10 minutes, and here's the result, the actual result of the mushroom pan, and we are now adding 1.5 spoons of the mushroom rub I made in the video to have a little bit more of a mushroom flavor in that sauce, and only 2 steps less until the sauce is completely ready. Add heavy cream, and now I decide how much heavy cream I add due to the color of the sauce. There could be a little bit lighter as well, so I added a dash of heavy cream more, and that's why you need a strong flavor in the beginning. Otherwise, the flavor would now flatten down with the heavy cream. That's really important. That's why you have to go with just the final step. I add nutmeg, and that's it. All in all, I'm quite happy with the sauce. Make sure not to cook it again, otherwise you have problems with the cream. And remove it, and we're now ready to serve that dish. And it's a steak with an awesome sauce of bacon, onions, mushroom, and some really, really great mushroom flavor due to the mushroom rub. I hope you liked that video. Of course, we are now cutting into and see how we did. That Iberico pork is a high quality pork. It can be eaten a little bit with a little bit pink inside if you want. I decided to go for an internal temperature of 62 till 60 degrees Celsius. And it's still juicy, and the flavor comes with the sauce, and everything is really, really delicious. I wish I could send you one of that pieces of pork. Of course, I'm gonna give this a shot right now. Thanks for watching so far. I would appreciate if you could leave a subscription if you haven't subscribed yet. Please make sure to hit that comment button and like it if you have something to comment. Ideas for the sauce appreciated. Make sure to visit my fan pages. Thanks for watching. I'm out. See you.